Welcome back to another VTScada training video. This is the third video in the Parameterized page series. A quick review. In order to realize the full power of those, you also need user-defined tag types, user-defined tag widgets, and a few expressions. In this video, we focus on user-defined tag types. Now, it is always a good idea to turn your context tags into types. Here are a few reasons why. First, if everything is a context, then to create a new something, maybe a pump, you have to hunt, and then copy and paste, and then edit every single child tag. But if a pump is a pump, you just create a new one where you need it. Second, if the design changes, you don't have to go back changing 100 pumps. You just change the type structure, and every instance is automatically updated. Third, tag widgets. Those are covered in the next video, but the short version is that it's a lot easier to link a pump widget to a pump type than to figure out which context represents the pump you want. Let's see how it's done by walking through an example with the pump from the last video. Open the context's properties and give it a type name that's a single word and that isn't a VTScada word. Click OK. Right-click on the tag in the tag browser to open the pop-up menu. Click Create New Type. Click OK when prompted about widgets. And you're done. You can now make new pumps just by clicking New Child and giving it a name and description. And thanks to the expressions I created in the last video, I don't have to configure any of the child tags. The address offset is used in every child tag to configure an I/O address, and the max flow sets the scaled max property of the analog status tag for the flow rate. What if one child tag needs to be different? No problem. Just go ahead and make the change. Note that when you do that, the child tag gets a star to show that it's being changed. Stars are helpful information. When you need to change the structure, either adding or removing child tags, or making some other change that should be pushed out into every instance, do it this way. Make a temporary instance first. Don't worry about doing any configuration. Make the design changes. Right-click on the parent and choose Redefine Type. Presto! Every existing instance has the new structure, and so will every new one. It's just that easy, but use care. There's a reason why this feature is protected by its own security privilege. And as always, there's more detail to be found in the documentation.